Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. In this video, we are going to study that what is a T state, what is a machine cycle and what is an instruction cycle related to the 8051 microcontroller. So let us start with our topic. The 8051 microcontroller, it is a programmable device. Programmable device means that we can write programs and for different types of applications in the 8051. Now, what are programs? They are a set of instructions. And these instructions are written in the memory of the microcontroller. And the microcontroller execute these instructions to get the result. Okay? Now, when these instructions, they are written in the program memory, so the microcontroller, what are the steps which the microcontroller performs? First, it is going to fetch the instruction, then it is going to decode that instruction, that what that instruction means, and then it is going to execute that instruction. So the whole working of the microcontroller, we can say it includes first fetching of the instruction, second decoding of the instruction, and third is execution of the instruction. So the first term, that is the instruction cycle, it is the time taken to execute the complete instruction by the microcontroller is called the instruction cycle. So we can write the definition of instruction cycle as the time required for completing the execution of an instruction. Now this time can be like 5 microseconds, 1 microsecond or 0.1 microsecond. So it can be anything in the time. Okay. So the complete time taken is called the instruction cycle. Now this instruction cycle, it consists of many machine cycles, because when an instruction is executed, then suppose that instruction involves that if you have to read a data from some memory location or from an input output port, or you have to write the data into the memory or to an input output port, okay, or if you have to add some numbers or subtract some numbers. So different types, the execution of an instruction, it involves various steps. So we can say that instruction cycle, it is divided into various machine cycles. Okay, so machine cycle means like we have in microcontroller, we have opcode fetch machine cycle, memory read machine cycle, memory write machine cycle, then input output read machine cycle and input output write machine cycle. So because all these, when an instruction is executed, it may involve read operation or write operation or fetching operation can be involved. So each instruction cycle is divided into various machine cycle. And we can say that so machine cycle, if we define what is a machine cycle, then machine cycle is defined as 12 oscillator periods. In every controller, in every microcontroller, we have an oscillator which provides the clock frequency to all the internal circuitry of the controller. Okay, so all the operations, that is read and write operations or any of the external operations like input output read or input output write operations, they are related with the oscillator frequency, that is clock frequency. So we can say that machine cycle, it is defined as 12 oscillator clock periods. Okay, so 12 oscillator clock period is equal to one machine cycle. Now in a machine cycle there are six states and each state it lasts for two oscillator clock periods. So if we divide the machine cycle, we will have six states in that, and each state is equal to two oscillator clock periods. So total we will have 12 oscillator clock periods. Now machine cycle, they can be of various types like opcode fetch, then we can have memory read or memory write, and we can have input output read or input output write. Okay, so we can say that instruction cycle, it consists of one or four machine cycle, or we can say that when an instruction is executed, the an instruction execution, it will consist of 1 to 4 machine cycles. Okay, so machine cycle, it is a part of instruction cycle. Now in machine cycle, it consists of 12 oscillator clock periods. So there is another term called T states. Now this T state, it is defined as one clock period. So T state is defined as one subdivision of the operation performed in one clock period. Means like a instruction cycle, it consists of various machine cycle. Now machine cycle, it consists of various T states. So in that machine cycle, suppose in one machine cycle, some operation is performed in one clock period. So that is called the T state. Or we can say that one clock period is equal to one T state. Okay, so in place of clock period also we can use the T state. So as I've said that machine cycle, it is each machine cycle, it has six states and each state consists of two oscillator clock periods. So we can say that each state of the machine cycle, it will consist of two T states. Okay, so if we talk about, this is our instruction cycle. In instruction cycle, we will have 1 to 4 machine cycles. And in machine cycle, we can have 2 to 12 T states. Okay, so smallest division is T state, then comes the machine cycle, and then comes the instruction cycle. So the complete execution of the instruction by the microcontroller, it consists of three parts. So it is divided into three parts. First part is the instruction cycle, that is time required to complete the execution of the complete instruction. Then comes machine cycle, in which instruction cycle it is divided into various machine cycle, like if the microprocessor, it is first fetching the instruction, then it is decoding, and then it is executing. So at the time of fetching, we will have opcode fetch machine cycle. Suppose it is performing memory read operation, so we will involve the memory read machine cycle. And suppose suppose that it is writing the memory, then we will have the memory write machine cycle. So instruction cycle, it will consist of various machine cycle. Now in every machine cycle, like in opcode fetch machine cycle, suppose it is completing in 4 clock periods. So it means that 4 T states are involved. Memory read, memory write, it is involving 3 T states. So total T states what we require is 20 states, okay, or 10 T states. So this is the definition of all the three terms: instruction cycle, machine cycle, and the T states. Now let's take an example to more clearly understand the meaning of these three terms. So in this example, we are given that a 8051 microcontroller is there, which is operated at 12 megahertz oscillator frequency, and we have to find the execution time for the following instructions, means how much time is taken to execute these instruction. First instruction we have is add A, 45H. Okay, so we have to add the contents of the accumulator and the contents of this memory location. Now this the number of machine cycles involved in this instruction is 1. Now oscillator clock frequency is given to us, that is 12 megahertz. If we calculate the clock period, so clock period is equals to 1 by clock frequency, that is reciprocal of the frequency. So we will have 1 by 12 megahertz, or we can say it is equal to 0.8333 microseconds. Or if we say that time taken okay, because in each machine cycle we have the 12 T states are there, so 12 into 0.833, so we will get 1 microsecond. Now this instruction, it will require one machine cycle only, that is opcode fetch, because opcode, when we are fetching this opcode, we directly get the address, we will get the data from this memory location, and second data is there in the accumulator, and result will be stored in the accumulator itself. So here one machine cycle is involved, so time taken to execute this instruction will be 1 microseconds. Next instruction we have is SUBBA, 55H. This is the 8-bit data which is available in the instruction. We have to subtract it from the accumulator along with the carry. Now here the number of machine cycle is 2. For one machine cycle, we require 1 microsecond. So for 2 machine cycle, we will require 2 microseconds. So 2 microsecond is the total time taken to execute this instruction. Next instruction we have is move DPTR and a 16-bit number. This also require 2 machine cycles. So 2 machine cycle equals to 2 microseconds. Fourth instruction we have is multiply A and B. This require 4 machine cycles. So 4 machine cycle is equal to 4 microseconds. So if we want to calculate the total time taken by total time taken to execute the instruction, if the clock frequency is given to us, first we will calculate the clock period. So one clock period is equal to 1 T states. We will calculate that how many machine cycles are involved in the instruction. Okay, number of machine cycles and how many means T states are involved in that machine cycle. So number of T states will be equal to the clock period. Okay, so in this way we can calculate the time taken to execute any of the instruction if we know the T state value, or if we know the clock period, and if we know the machine cycles involved in that instruction. So in this video we studied that what is called a T state instruction cycle and machine cycle in 8051 microcontroller. So I hope that this topic is clear to you. Thank you.